Thank you, co-panelists. Thank you very much, and we thank you and your nation, First Nations, for hosting us and giving us and sharing with us this land. And it is our tradition to acknowledge the land and the people, and we apologize, it was an oversight. Rabbi. Rabbi Michael, thank you. Father Damian, thank you very much for your nice words. This is amazing, and I'm not exaggerating. You see that gentleman who read earlier with his beautiful voice, Imam Ali? He said he's a, like me, we memorize the Quran by heart, so we don't need the book. We have to review once in a while, but I told him read anywhere. And the top, and he doesn't know English. Now I'm speaking, he doesn't know what I'm saying. And he speaks only Indonesian and Arabic, very fluent in Arabic. And he read the verses, the most appropriate verses in the Bible and the Quran. That's, but in the Quran there is more details. That conversation between Noah, the father, and his son, when he was telling him to join the ship, and he refused, so there was a conversation. And he said, Dad, don't worry, I'll go to the highest peak of a mountain, and I will be protected. He said, Noah said, nobody will be saved today. Everybody's gone. And as I heard him, I said, maybe God Almighty wants to remind us that, you know what, even if you're a prophet, even if you are the most pious person, you can never give faith to your children. I'm a believer. There is no way you can make your children believers. You can never give faith to your children. You can give them food, you can give them clothes, you can give them shoes, you can give them education, you can train them, you can build their muscles, but you will never be able to make them believe in something. You know, there was this little boy, he asked his father to go with him to the shore. He said, Dad, they're 4 years old. Daddy, come with me. He pulled him to the shore, and there was a seagull dead. He said, Dad, look what happened to this bird. He said, don't worry, son. He's gone to heaven. He said, oh, and then did God throw him back down? You see, children don't separate between spiritual and physical. The entity is one. When you're at that level to understand that we are not human beings, we are spiritual beings going through a human experience, then you understand that we're beyond what you see here. And that's why this beautiful message that we have through Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, who said, when God looks at any human being, he looks at his or her heart and his deeds. And he never looks at his wealth or her wealth and the shape and form and the looks. We have become so superficial, and we are making our children superficial, subliminally, intentionally, willingly, unwillingly. And our behavior, because our thoughts become our behavior. And without being conscious of that, because of our greed, and I'm not saying you, in general, we're greedy. We want more. We want more. Not more of closeness to God and to humanity like these beautiful organizations we have, and I'll acknowledge later. But we're more defining success based on how much possessions we have on us, with us, behind us. And then we expect our children who see us panting, literally panting over gold, over cars, over houses, over whatever you like, cheesecake, over cheesecake, whatever food. I mean, I'm saying cheesecake because I'm hungry. We don't have cheesecake tonight. Whatever we're panting over, and I use the word panting because sometimes this is why people are doing anything. Now things are done on behalf of our religion, but these guys are crooks. It's all about the money. Two Canadians 2 weeks ago, and I feel very bad, and I spoke yesterday to the minister, federal minister. He came to see us here, and I said, is there something that we could have done as Muslims? Two Canadians were killed, you know, and I mentioned to our RCMP friends here yesterday, is there, I feel like I could do something. These guys in Philippines, they have a name, I don't want to mention it, I don't want to spoil my fast, and they are calling themselves whatever, but their job is they kidnap people from the borders with Malaysia and Indonesia. And in Philippines, it's many islands, Indonesia, and then they take them, it doesn't matter. And all their business is asking ransom. And they call themselves Muslims. Or, and you know the news can tell you a lot. All of them are greedy for power, greedy for money, greedy for, you know, subjugating other people. The sincere spiritual people, they don't even have to say words to their children. It'll be lived. It'll be felt in the home. So how do we pass the religion to our children? We have to be sincere. Sincere. Because what comes from the heart reaches the hearts. However, in our tradition, do I still have time? In our tradition, as you said, we do not teach religion to the child, it's by example, until he's 7 years old. We teach them how to pray. They join us in my home, and I'm sure typical in Muslim homes, children, they see us praying, they join us. We don't tell them. But at 7, we start teaching them how to clean themselves in the washrooms, how to wash themselves, how to change their clothes, and then they pray. By the age of 10, we demand that they should pray 5 times a day. But we don't, you know, we this is our tradition. So we have phases. We have the first 7, then we have the 3 years, and then we have the 4 years, teenage, and then we have, you know, this. So we have a saying that goes like this. Before 7, treat them like princes. After 7, treat them like, before 7, treat them like kings. After 7, treat them like princes. After 14, treat them like, you know, colleagues. So to give them that leadership. So religion and spirituality is handed over by example, and you have to be sincere. This is basically, my time is up. And is it time for Adhan? Yes. So we have 1 more minute while we are, we don't have Q&A, unfortunately, but I would encourage everybody, now we're having a full house, to fill up all the chairs and have discussion over the iftar. Now, as you see, we will break fast on dates. Date is the fruit of the desert, okay? Where there's no fruits, dates can survive. It has a lot of vitamins, vitamin A, iron, and then we drink water. And then we will, of course, serve the soup after that. Now, before I go and we'll call for the prayer, I usually call, I'm going to ask one of our imams here to call the prayer. Let me acknowledge few organizations, and I have to. But if I forget someone throughout the dinner, remind me. My very good friend, please stand up. Reverend Brian. Reverend Brian McIntosh has joined us with his beautiful wife. I gave the service in his church a couple months ago, and he gave the speech at the Friday prayer. It happens only in Canada. And Rabbi is coming, huh? You're coming, huh? And I'm going. I did it before in Bet Zedek. Association of Canadian Muslims and Jews, Shahid. I don't see Barbara here. Shahid Iftar. The people who are keeping us safe and keeping our country safe, Please pray for them. May God bless them and protect them and help them and always enlighten them. We had a conference yesterday. Please stand up, folks. You don't like to be known? No, just stand up. So we have Faram, Andrea, Roger, and Wajid. Thank you for being with us. Also, Princess Margaret Cancer Foundation. Laura is here in person. And please, you see this one here? Stand up, Laura. Don't be shy. Don't worry. This is not the first time here. You see this? This gentleman here with the red hat, you talk to him throughout the dinner. He's signing up for the golf tournament. We're golfing this year again. Our annual golf tournament is actually becoming a very popular golf tournament in the GTA. So this year we have some, we are raising, we have to finish the $200,000 for Princess Margaret Cancer Foundation and Etobicoke General. No, we're at 2 minutes here. Yeah, because that's Toronto time. We're in Mississauga. We're in the West. I starve them another minute, more rewards. No, sorry. I want to acknowledge Human Concern International. The president is right there, and he is doing great things for Syrian refugees and a lot of good things. And of course, you heard Heart to Heart Foundation. If I missed anybody, please forgive me. Kari Dasrizal, let's call the Adan, please. Thank you. Oh, sorry. Peel Police Chief was here last year. Justin Trudeau was here last year, so we couldn't get them. They're busy. Chief sent her, and please stand up. Beautiful Peel Region Police. Thank you. Remind me, or if I forget somebody.